السلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. On behalf of Markaz Sahaba, the voice of Ahlus Sunnah wal Jama'ah, we present to you lesson number 2197 of our daily Nasiha and advice. Today, with the grace and mercy of Almighty Allah Azza wa Jalla, we focus on the second of Jumad al-Ula. An Asib ibn Humayd, he is a Tabi'i, Rahimahullah, he states, Qala sa'altu Aisha radiallahu anha. I asked Siddiqa, Sayyid Aisha radiallahu anha, obviously behind the curtain and the veil, Mada kana Nabiyyu sallallahu alayhi wa sallam yaftatihu bihi qiyam al-layl. When Mustafa Habibuna sallallahu alayhi wa sallam woke up early part of the morning, 2-3 o'clock, so what would the Master alayhi salatu salam read and recite before the Tahajjud Salat? Qalat, she said, Siddiqa Sayyida Aisha radiallahu anhu Asim, لَقَدْ سَأَلْتَنِي أَنْ شَيْءٍ مَا سَأَلَنِي أَنْهُ أَحَدٌ قَبْلَكَ. You asked me something that no one before you asked me then. And from here we understand the wisdom of Mustafa sallallahu alayhi wa sallam marrying so many wives and so forth, so every sunnah of Nabi alayhi salatu salam could be preserved, and our mother Siddiqa Sayyida Aisha radiallahu anha, 2,210 ahadith. So she was always teaching the people, the sahaba, the tabi'in, what happened in the darkness of the night and in privacy and so forth. So, kana yukabbiru ashra, Habibuna sallallahu alayhi wa sallam woke up. Then the Master, peace be upon him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, would say Allahu Akbar 10 times. Wa yahmadu ashra. Then Nabi alayhi wa sallam would say Alhamdulillah 10 times. Wa yahmadu ashran. Wa yusabbihu ashra. Then Subhanallah 10 times. Wa yastaghfiru ashra. 10 times istighfar. Wa yaqul. And after that used to say, there was no need for the Master alayhi salam to beg Allah for forgiveness, but ta'aliman lihadhi ummah, to set the precedent for humanity and posterity. Allahumma ghfirli. So for me and you, the translation will be, O Allah, forgive me my vices, my sins. For the Master alayhi salam, it will be, forgive me for my mistakes. So not sins, you can't translate that, because anbiya are ma'soom and protected, and to set the precedent for humanity and posterity. Allahumma ghfirli wahdini, guide me. But Nabi sallam is the most guided to set the lesson precedent for humanity. Warzuqni, ya Allah, grant me risk and sustenance. Today the whole world is worried about that. Wa'afini, and grant me afia. One word and had an encyclopedic meaning. Give me health, give me wealth, give me honor, protection, safety, no kidnapping, no hijacking, all that. So imagine every day Habibuna sallallahu alayhi wa say these easy words. So Allah, first of all, give us tawfiq that we can wake up early part of the morning, and then we practice on the sunnah. The hadith is mentioned in Ibn Majah, and in that way there it becomes a reality in our life. We know that today Monday is the first, but for us we say second, because we already one day earlier for people to give advices and them. So start this year, even if you can't do it tahajjud time, other times we do it. So tahajjud time will be the best time, but other times will be permissible and acceptable. Barakallahu fiqh. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.